Salamta, Rastafari. Now that we're doing this whole movement and spirit, we're just gonna put this out there because it's been in our hearts and minds for, well, since the foundations of the world, right? It's always, and this is concerning Ethiopia and the well-being of beautiful Zion and our role and responsibility. Even though it's always been in our hearts and minds, it's like another comment lit the match. It sparked a different perspective on the excuse me, on the situation, on the scenario. And so first let me say that we're always kind of thinking of how to get to our family in Ethiopia because because it is what it is, and it's, we know in our hearts that it is our job to restore beautiful Zion to what it was intended to be, to what it once was, And so, but we read a comment on one of the videos, which is proof in itself how we were really kind of like pushing towards reaching out to Ethiopians in particularly. And so the video, we don't know what it's called, we forgot, but it has to do with Ethiopia being rich and how people say it's poor and one of the poorest countries in the world. Well, that's not true. It is in fact the richest. And as far as the famine, the only famine is the, the lack of word of the Almighty. That's the only famine, and so that's all scriptural. And but then, because of this comment, and first let we make mention of the comment. And so this, we've noticed that this individual, and we give much thanks, we've noticed that oftentimes he comments with a simple thank you on some of those videos that I feel are the ones that I would really, really, really hope that would reach the world. And it, more specifically, it's the videos that have to do with putting out the truth of Ethiopia and how, and I mean, I don't have ideas of what truth I'm even talking about, but because Ethiopia is just true in general as a whole, and so it's difficult to go into all the lies that are made manifest, in the present time, which will be done away with, I assure all and I. And so let us continue. By so the individual he and so that kind of like it made it raised, not raised, it kind of like created, it raised up, or it was born, a relationship was born. I mean, I don't know the individual, I don't even know if it's a male, female, but the fact that a simple thank you on the videos that I really wouldn't want anything else but to have those really, really affect the minds of the world. And so it built a relationship. And so with this comment, another simple thank you on this recent Ethiopia is beautiful video, it kind of like it just sparked an idea, not an idea, a truth that will be made manifest. I mean, it's no question, no doubt about that. It's only just it's a process, it's patience. From now on, it's the patience of the saints, you see. It's like, it's not that if the kingdom is gonna come, if the restoration is gonna take place, if Ethiopia is gonna recover, that's all a done deal. It's for sure. It's only a matter of patience and time. And so it's like, as long as we hang in there, we'll bear witness to the word being fulfilled in its entirety. And so and so what even though we've tried to kind of like not even videos, but on our own time, try to do things to more like more importantly, the Ethiopia, how to reach out to the Ethiopians. But this simple thank you in this last Ethiopian is beautiful video. It's not called that, right? But we don't remember, and so that is kind of like a reference to that video. Nonetheless, it gave us the idea of of reaching out to those that are more in a better situation and well, actually, that are more capable of reaching out to larger amounts of Ethiopians. And so, like, I mean, look at me. I'm not even, I wouldn't even be considered Ethiopian, right? And so, let's be honest. I mean, there's a limited amount of reaching out that I would be able to do. But we give thanks for this comment. And so, it kind of gave us the idea of reaching out to those in a position where they are able to reach out to even more of their own people. And we did this with one of the Spanish Rastafari videos because we tried to get to the Mayan descendants because they're trying to do their whole rituals again, and they're trying to do the culture and the ceremonies and traditions, practices, and we're not against that. The only thing is that they don't know that what they were expecting, what the Mayas were expecting in the whole 2012 and stuff like that, is our father, Kedamawi Haile Selassie. They were waiting for Christ. The whole world is waiting for Christ, right? And so we knew that we can't reach those people because they lack the communication such as computers, and they lack even the basic necessities such as water and electricity. And I mean, they're downpressed. Just think about it. They inherit, you know, these lands full of ancient ruins that are really worth a lot of money if you do the wrong things with them. And so it's obvious that indigenous peoples that are inheritors of these ancient cities, it's only logical that they will be downpressed, and they will be, you know, they will be I mean, if not like sought out to be completely annihilated, at least shoved into a dark corner where they are not even known to exist. And so this is the case, and we can't get to them. So what do? We get to the people that can get to them and pass along the message without them receiving it directly from us, because we don't. I mean, that's why all the civilizations in the times of old just crumbled, because they ignorantly started doing stuff they weren't supposed to do. And we came to the conclusion it's not even their fault, because I mean, up until these latter days, the fulfillment of much of scripture had not taken place, and so they really didn't have any other way to testify to the true and living, at least the Father, and then that in itself resurrects the Son in a way. And so, without getting into all the details, so our idea is to reach out to those of Ethiopian descent or in located in Ethiopian Ethiopian to those that are in close to Ethiopians and stuff like that. And so we wrote a letter to the Ethiopian Orthodox Church, and so we haven't mailed it, but we will. And I mean, we might even mail one to just random Ethiopian Orthodox churches throughout the United States, because that's who we thought we could reach, and that they are in a position where if they seek to walk in the way of Getai Jesus Christus, as they so claim, that they will do what they can to help in this movement, in this progress, this effort towards the ultimate good towards the ultimate good of our good Creator. And so it's like Ethiopians going to their churches, they have like Bible classes, they have they celebrate feasts and stuff like that. And so we wrote a letter to ask that they do what it is possible, and even beyond that, to do what is impossible, and not to get into politics and stuff like that, but but they probably will. But that's not on us, you know. We did what we could, reaching out to them, asking that they reach out to the rest. And it's not even that the rest that are reached out to, if it so be the case, it will be the case. Not in all areas, right? But it will come to pass. And so it's not even them that we're trying to target. It's getting into their minds, the people, the Ethiopians, or at least that have some kind of relativity to Ethiopia or Ethiopians. It's to get these church officials, to get those people, to get the message across to some family members. You know, maybe they have a grandma still in Ethiopia. Maybe they visit some family members every once in a while, or they're in constant contact with someone else that is in constant contact. And so that's what we're trying to do, initiate. And so the letter is pretty much just saying that, just the truth be told. We're not seeking to be on to force the truth of our God and Father. As a matter of fact, it won't, it's not necessary. The truth will be received by them who are of the truth, but the message has to be put out. You see, how can Ethiopia repent if they don't know what they've done wrong? It's like we've we know this for a fact. It's like when you're gonna turn 21, your mind is thinking, okay, as soon as I'm 21, I'm gonna buy beer and I'm going to go drink at a bar and stuff like that. And it's almost like ones take it as a must, like a life or death, you know, situation. When you're 21, you buy beer because all your life that's what it's been forced upon you. It's like you're gonna be 21, you're gonna be able to drink, you're gonna be able to go to the bars, you're gonna be, yeah, as soon as you're 21, you're gonna drink, we're gonna go drink, and we're gonna buy drinks, and you're gonna be able to buy us drinks. So surely enough, an individual turns 21, the first thing he'll do is go buy beer. And but in his mind was never the option not to buy beer, because your parents drink, your uncles drink, everyone drinks when you're 21. Everyone drinks and everyone is allowed to. So you just think it's second nature that, oh, I'm 21, I'm supposed to buy beer. But no one ever tells you that you don't have to. It's an option. It's not a requirement of a U.S. citizen once one turns 21. And so that example is to kind of like shine some light on how are Ethiopians to repent from something they are not even aware of. It's like maybe the older crowds do kind of are at fault, but even them, they were fooled into this. And so them keeping their pride, false pride, will never just on their own think that maybe what they did was wrong. And so and the facts of the matter and the testimony of the present times and the situation in the motherland, is not enough to spark that question within their minds. Was it really such a good idea? And so because of that false pride, it's they'll even confront it, but you know, that'll be thrown to the to the subconscious, you know. That's where the subconscious kind of like takes control and kind of like puts the frontal lobe to the side and okay, we'll take it from here. This is not to be remembered, not to be digested, not to be received. This never happened. And so that's kind of like the psychological aspect of it, of you know, that false pride, having the devil himself rule you from within. And so anyways, but the people that I'm thinking are the ones to reach are the children. And so if they're never going to be told their history, they're going to see the churches, they're going to know that they have a long history, but it's never going to make sense because of what they see. It's like growing up to a white Christ, white Jesus Christus, a Cesar Borgia, better, more correct. It's like I never bought into it. I'm like, that ain't good. I'd rather be the worst and the most evil and be satanic to the fullness of the word, extent of the word, than to follow you hypocrites, you know, because I knew what it was. I didn't I come from Catholic background. How bad it's even worse than Christianity, I would say. And then the fact that, the more specifically the family that, I was placed in, it's like it's Catholicism like watered down to the fullness, and so like I knew for a fact that's so who that is not good, and so you bunch of hypocrites, I'm not gonna listen to you. And so basically what I'm trying to say is that sure, like the children and Ethiopians might look around and see these ancient churches, but what they experience is a whole different story, and so it's not gonna click. And so I'm thinking that just to put out the truth, Ethiopians have been lied to, and it's not to tell them, oh yeah, His Majesty is God and stuff like that. Yes, he is, but they will find that, well, if they are willing, they will find that out on their own. You see, it's when you know that you've been lied to that you change your opinion. Then it allows for you to kind of think differently about things. It's like, cause you know the what mistake it was that put you in the situation. It's not your nation, it's not your history, it's not your beliefs, your religion, it's not you. It's like when we took on the William Lynch letter, it's like, oh, we knew we weren't bad people. It's this fool right here that caused all this chaos. And it's like it all made sense. I went running to my mom like, you won't believe this, I'm not that bad, like I was all happy, and I'm still happy because that curse was broken. And so it's like it all made sense. It allowed me to be like, yeah, like I'm kind of like, so think better of myself and be like, yeah, so I'm not like the worst, and I'm not gonna end up in prison the rest of my life, and I can do good and stuff like that. It's these wicked devils that kind of made this happen. And so I'm thinking it'll give them that idea. And plus, it'll allow them an option, most of all. It's like, we're not even saying that because they know their history, that they're gonna take on responsibility for it seems much like a heavy burden, but they know it not, Jesus Christus, if such thoughts come to mind. So continuing, but given the option, you don't have to buy beer. You don't have to drink. You could, because you're 21, legally you're allowed, but it doesn't mean that it is a requirement. And so if Ethiopians are told the truth, and the government is not going to do it, the school system is not going to do it, we know the churches are not going to do it, but at least if we could have them kind of like work with us in the sense that whatever amount of truth that we could get them to pass on to the people is more than enough. I mean, we as Rastafari will handle this on our own if necessary, but it's a good idea, and it's all because of a good comment, and we appreciate that. And so let us continue. And what it is that I think that the and feel free to comment on this and to let I know what one thinks as far as what truth should be presented. But I think it's the whole. The envy, just let them know, listen, Ethiopia is the like the center of the universe, and these haters kind of fooled you into giving that all up, you were already good, right? But the serpent offered you evil too, so now you got to deal with evil, but you were all good, and so it's not your fault, it's not even your parents' fault, it's these haters out here did this to hurt you because they're haters. I mean, they can't accept the fact that you are of the center of the universe. And so if we could get that in their minds and let them know how the whole revolution was a mistake, and how and it is necessary to let them know that His Imperial Majesty, not to force upon them who he is and the truth of him, but the truth of his works. If you don't believe me, like Geta Jesus Christus says, if you don't believe me, for I forgot the scriptures, excuse that, but he says something like, if you don't believe me for blank blank blank, excuse that, bad example, right? But nonetheless, it's in a good it's for a good cause, like we often say. He says, at least believe me for the works, And so if we could show the works, and if they could see the works, you know, His Majesty wasn't that bad of a person. Well, how come we did this to him, you know? His Majesty, at least one of the individuals that claims to have seen him the moment that he was supposedly frozen, like, and that the room smelled like ether when he supposedly passed away, or passed over. He mentioned something like that in that video. Someone mentioned that he was crying, looking out the window, and he was crying, and this is His Imperial Majesty, and he said, "Oh, Ethiopia, how have I wronged you?" It's not even like, "Did I wrong you?" No, it's like, "How? Tell me, and I'll do what I can to do it better, to make it work," you know. And that's, you know, that's the humility of our God and Father, goes to show. But they don't know, because no one has showed them, and so they don't know the true character, life, and character of His Imperial Majesty, and they must know, and they're not gonna tell them. You know, the people running the show actually did what they could to get him, His Imperial Majesty, out of the picture. And so we're thinking, trying to get to this message to people that could get it to more large amounts of Ethiopians that hopefully could get it to the mainland, or if there's any other shortcut or any other way. And this isn't all we're going to do. I mean, the letters will be written and they will be sent out, but as Rastafari, it is our responsibility. You know, we commented on that comment that it came to, a lot of things came to mind. Listen, we were spared the suffering for a reason. So if we don't put in the work that we are required to put in, is we might as well, I don't know, we don't understand anything that we don't seek to follow. And so we'll leave that at that. But we were spared. We were rooted out of the homeland, and we were spared that suffering, but with the responsibility to go back and put everything in order to replace His Majesty in His rightful throne, you know, as the ruler of everything, of the universe and beyond. And so it is our responsibility. We were rooted out, and you know, we were blown with the wind. Some of us landed on good ground here in the desert, in the wilderness, and now we must grow in the truth of Gita Jesus Christus, in the power of His Imperial Majesty, Kedama Kalesdasi, via the Spirit within I and I, the Holy Spirit that we take on. And so now we are to grow like trees planted alongside the rivers of water, and we are to bear fruit in given season. And so this whole famine, we made mention, if Ethiopia is hungry, is because the trees have not bear fruit. If we're not bringing forth fruit, if out of I and I, Rastafari, so-called, is not flowing like abundant rivers of water, then how is the people, how are they to drink? We do not offer bread, we do not give drink. How is Ethiopia to be cured? And so this is all on us, and this is what it is, you know. We were placed in the place that we were positioned strategically to move on ahead, where such obstruction is not possible, where obstruction is, or it cannot be impeded, you know, where we cannot be stopped. You know, this is basically even referencing to the movement and the spirit we are to be. We're let the east wind, you know, direct us and kind of like go back to the east and bear fruit. You know, we were gonna be harvested out of the west. And so, but you know, to give fruit and do what it is our responsibility to do. And so that is to feed the world with much drink and bread. And so, I mean, we'll just end it at that, but there's so much to say. If we are truly thankful for having had the privilege to avoid the situation in the motherland, then we must take on the responsibility to do our work that is intended for us, you know, to serve as a vessel for the Almighty to get His grand design to be made manifest and fully filled. We're thinking of something, but it's not coming to mind. So give us just 1 second. We really wanted to make mention that, yeah, it's not going to happen. So we'll just hold on for another time. So we give thanks to all and die. I hope some agree. And if there's if anyone's have like any ideas, you know, just email, call, whatever. But this is serious, you know, because it's not fair. It's not fair. And Ethiopia does not have to be. It's like we said, it's the center of the universe. It's rich. It's no need to be going through what it's going through. But my people, you know, they forgot exactly how it goes. But my people perish for lack of knowledge. And so we must make that knowledge available for them. So we give thanks to all. Shalom Rastafari.